Hi guys, my name is Shrikant Idam. Today we are going to discuss about the topic billing and types of purchasing instance option. So how exactly Amazon bills you for the instance? So when you create an instance in AWS, so what exactly happen? So when you start your instance and boot it, then from that time billing will start. So if you are going to terminate your instance, the billing will stop. But if you are going to stop the instance or shut down the instance, here you are not terminating it, you are just shutting down your instance, then you are not going to bill for it. You are not, Amazon is not going to bill for your instance, but it is going to bill for your storage. It means hard disk, the data which you are going to save in your storage, so you have to pay for it. Okay, so in Amazon, pay for second is available for Linux and Ubuntu operating system, not for Windows. For Windows, they charge you hourly. So billing will be done hourly, not for monthly. But only for the Linux operating system, we have an option called pay for second. So we will go to the next topic, EC2 purchasing options. So here we have six types of purchasing options. So whenever you're going to select a instance, there we have on-demand free tier. So you can select any on-demand free tier instance. They will not charge for you. They will not going to charge for you it. And second option is dedicated instance. So dedicated instance is like you have a physical machine shared with you. Second one is dedicated host. Dedicated instance is a physical machine which will be shared on demand, and dedicated host is a separate hardware machine which will be shared with you. Spot instance, a instance which is available, unused instance or a bid instance, the price keep increasing and decreasing, so you can buy any instance over there. Schedule instance, this instance are reserved according to your schedule. You can schedule it for like for few hours or 2 years. And reserved instance, so if you go for this instance, even if you don't use it, once you buy it, you can reserve the instance for weekly, daily or yearly basis. So let's go in detail. On-demand instance. So when you go for the on-demand instance, AWS on-demand instance are virtual servers that run in AWS or AWS relational database service are purchased as at a fixed rate per hour. So what it means is, in case if you want to buy a virtual server, instance in AWS, you can select any instance. It can be instance with a database, instance with any other requirement. You can purchase it at a hourly price. Okay. AWS recommends using on-demand instance for applications with short-term irregular workloads that cannot be interrupted. In case if you want to test anything, any application, and you want to buy you are looking for a machine which is readily available, you can go for the on-demand instance. So you can select your instance with the hardware, whatever the hardware requirement you need, and you can install the application on it. So it is readily available. You can pay it on a fixed price per hour. They are also suitable for use during testing and development of applications on EC2. As I explained you earlier, if you want to do any testing for the applications, you can select this on-demand instance. With on-demand, you only pay for the instance you use. That's right. The use of on-demand instances frees you from the cost and complexities of planning. That's right. So what Already you will have an instance available with the hardware requirement, whichever you need. You just have to select it and you can install your required applications. Purchasing and maintaining hardware and transforms what are commonly large fixed costs into much smaller variable cost. So instead of paying huge amount of money, you can pay for the fixed hourly price. Pricing is pre-instance hour consumed for each instance. For the time on instance is launched until it's terminated or stopped. Once you launch the instance, once you start your instance, and once then you terminate the instance, you will be paying for that only. Each partial instance hour consumed will be billed per second for Linux instance and as full hour for other instances. If you are going to go for the Linux instance, you will be billed for the second. But if you go for other instances, for like a Windows operating system, you have to pay hourly. So the second topic is dedicated instance and dedicated host. So what is the difference between it? First, before we go for the dedicated instance, we will understand what is dedicated host. An Amazon EC2 dedicated host is a physical server with EC2 instance capacity fully dedicated to your use. So in case if you want a physical machine with a good hardware configuration, you can go for the dedicated host. So Amazon will assign a physical machine with good configuration. They will share you as an instance for your personal use. So it will be little charged extra. Dedicated host can help you hardware compliance requirement and reduce cost by allowing you to use your existing server bound software licenses. So in few companies, they will have a compliance requirement. Like for a few applications, it's mandatory to have a physical machine. Okay, so in that case, they can select this option, dedicated host. So server bound software licenses, what does it mean? Means like some applications needs to be installed on a physical machine only because they have a socket license, and few VMs needs to be installed on a physical machines only. So the fourth point, if you observe, pay for physical host that is fully dedicated to running your instance and bring your existing per socket, per code, per VM software license to reduce cost. So for this requirement, you need to go for the dedicated host. And if you have any compliance requirement in your office, in your organization, then they go for the dedicated host. And coming to the dedicated instance are run in a VPC on hardware that is dedicated to a single customer. So if you have a virtual private network in cloud, and they can go for the dedicated instance, and it will be assigned to a single customer. Okay, because dedicated instance will be not available in on demand, because it is available in public. Here, in case if any client is using dedicated host and he has like a extra hardware which is not being used, that extra hardware will be shared here in dedicated instance in a virtual private network. Because virtual private network instances are not available in public, so that is the reason that it will be shared here to a single customer. Your dedicated instances are physically isolated at a host hardware level instance that belong to other AWS account. As I explained you, this dedicated host is purchased by some other user, right, and is not utilizing all the resources. So whatever the resources are left, it will be shared as a dedicated instances, and it will be shared only in VPC network. Dedicated instances may share hardware with other instances that are not dedicated instance. It is the same thing which I explained you. pay for dedicated instances on demand, save up to 70% by purchasing reserved instances, or save up to 90% purchasing spot instances. Pay for the dedicated instance on demand, save up to 70%. So if you are going to pay for the dedicated instance in on demand, you can save up to 70% because they are going to charge you by hour. And if you are going to go for the reserved instances, like if you want a dedicated instance like for a particular time, then they will get a discount of 70%, and in spot instances it is 90%. Spot instances, like, it can be terminated any time, like if price is going to increase. So I suggest go for the reserved instance option or for the on demand option. Next we have spot instances. The term all explain itself, explain you that, like, Amazon EC2 spot instances are, it lets you take advantage of unused EC2 capacity in the AWS cloud spot instance available up to 90% discount compared to on-demand prices. So on-demand prices are, on-demand instances are, they are going to charge you hourly, right? But in spot instances, they will give you a discount of 90% because they are the instances which are currently available, which are being not used. Okay, for example, if I have an instance, I'm not using it, I'm going to use it next day. So they are going to give you discount 90% to use my instance. And in case if I turned up today and I'm going to use my instance, you will get a notification you will get a 2 minutes notification to shut down the instance. So that's the reason spot instances have more discounts. You can use spot instances for various test and development workloads. It is also like for testing. You also have options to hibernate, stop or terminate your spot instances when EC2 reclaims the capacity back with 2 minutes of notice. So when you go for the spot instances, and if Amazon want to reclaim the spot instance in back, it will give you 2 minutes of notice. Schedule instance. Schedule reserve instances enable you to purchase capacity reservations that reoccur on a daily, weekly or monthly basis with a specific start time duration for a 1 year term. So if you go for the schedule instance, here you have daily, weekly and monthly plan. Okay, you can choose any either of them, and here you have to go for mandatory 1 year term. You reserve the capacity in advance so that you know it is available when you need it. So when you go for the schedule instance, you have the it is available when you need it, because you are going to select 1 year term with daily, weekly, monthly basic plans. You pay for the time that the instance are scheduled even if you do not use them. Of course, if you have went for the schedule instance, no one going to use it, because whenever you want it, it is available and you are going to charge for it. Schedule instances are a good choice for workloads that do not run continuously but do not run on a regular schedule. Yes, so whenever I need it, I need that instance on that particular time. Purchase instance that are always available on the specified recurring schedule for a 1 year term. So this instance is available for 1 year term and it is a recurring schedule, like daily, weekly, monthly. Reserved instances. Amazon EC2 reserved instances provide a significant discount compared to on-demand pricing and provide a capacity reservation when used in a specific availability zone. So these reserved instances are instances which are available in a particular availability zone. So depending upon the availability zone as well, we will get discount. For example, in North Virginia, like a few instances are available and they are not being used by anyone, you may get more discount in that zone. Reserved instances gives you the option to reserve a database instance for a 1 or 3 year term plan and in turn receive a significant discount compared to the on-demand instance for the database instance. So what it explains is, so if you are looking for like an application like you want to use it for a long term and you don't want to be charged for an hourly basis, then you can go for this option, reserved instance, and this option is available for 1 year and 3 year term. So when you go for this high term, you will get a more discount because it is being reserved for you. So for example, like if you are going to stay in a hotel for longer time, you may get a discount, right? So this is about the instances, guys. Thank you for watching. Meet you in next class.